Hello, welcome to the News Digest this week with me, Vivian Kamsimi. There have been internal bickerings within the FDC party over leadership. We sit down with their spokesperson, Honorable Ibrahim Ssemujju Nganda, to shed some light on some of their salient issues. Welcome, Honorable.
Thank you.
What are the party's plans ahead of the 2026 elections?
The law on political parties was changed by Parliament. The changes that were made, for example, the lower organs of the parties were allowed to take decisions on behalf of the delegates' conference in case you are unable to meet because of COVID. As a result, our term was extended by 3 years. It is ending in July this year, which is about a month away. We are now organizing elections. And the last NEC meeting last week was supposed to be discussing structures and the roadmap and the guidelines. And because of other things, we are unable to discuss that item. But you are going to be discussing that because, unlike other parties, in FDC at least we still have elections and they will take place. We FDC leaders have been changing and they will continue changing. So those elections are coming. 2026 elections at the moment is not our priority.
So this party election that you're organizing, does that effectively end Engineer Patrick Amriat Obo's term as president of the FDC party?
Under the FDC constitution, we have term limits. Engineer Amriat has been a president for one term, so he's eligible for re-election. I've been a spokesperson for one time. If I wanted, then I would be eligible. But the decision of who becomes the FDC next leader is a decision of the delegates' conference. Until nominations have been picked, I don't know. We are planning around September if everything goes well, because it must be preceded with elections at the villages, because we are not a Kampala party. So every election every village must choose its leaders. The village people will choose parish, parish will choose sub-county will choose district, and district will choose national. So we'll go through that exercise. And that's when we'll have a new delegates conference that will choose new leaders.
Do you plan to offer yourself as party spokesperson again?
No. I have never offered myself to serve in any position in FDC. I have been asked by colleagues, and so I have been deployed by the FDC supporters. I am waiting. If they don't ask me to serve anywhere, I will serve nowhere.
Will the party need Dr. Kizza Besigye to run for presidency come 2026 in order to revive and restore the party's glory?
No, you see, Dr. Besigye, first, he was serving his second term as FDC leaders, and as FDC leader, I think 2015, not sure. And then he chose not to complete the term. He said, I don't want to be the FDC leader beyond this period. He also, by his own, said, I am not going to participate in elections if they continue being organized the way they are organized. In fact, at that time, people said he had failed. For us, we will manage. Those who said VSG had failed and came to manage met the same problems, terror. So VSG, his focus is on changing the way elections are held in Uganda. It's not to be a candidate. Because if you wanted, what does it take to be a candidate? Just paying money and you present your S6 certificate and you'll be a candidate.
The FDC's glory, is it in need of restoration?
If you participate in elections and are cheated, and for you think it's glory. So if there are people who think being the main opposition by numbers is glorious, at least it's not the FDC. For us, every after election, you saw us the following day, we were on the street protesting because we did not get what we deserved from these elections. So really, FDC has never enjoyed any glory. The glory would be if the country has ended Mr. Museveni's rule and we now have a new administration that will follow the rules of the game.
Honorable Ibrahim Ssemujju Nganda, thank you very much for speaking to us. That has been the week's News Digest. Until next week, I am Vivian. Come see me.